This incredible sunrise is in Wanaka, on the South Island of New Zealand, about an hour's drive from Queenstown. With a reputation around the world as a ski destination, I'm going to show you what you can do here from sunrise to sunset in the summertime. Starting on Lake Wanaka, with an hour of stand-up paddleboarding guided by Chris from Paddle Wanaka. For those of you who want to try this out, Chris has a few tricks on how it's done.
The first way, really, if you can stand with your feet shoulder width apart, a nice little bend, keeping your weight above your feet, yeah. And looking on the horizon, grabbing the top of that paddle, paddling forward, and you're away laughing.
So just keep the eyes level at the horizon, because whenever I look at you is when I start to get a little...
Yeah.
The heart of Wanaka is located right at the edge of the lake, surrounded by mountains. Unlike the fast pace of Queenstown, Wanaka has managed to hold on to its village feel. And that's why it is one of my all-time favourite places to visit. The centre of town is big enough to spend a couple of days exploring the local shops and small enough to be able to do it on foot. My tip is to check out Fideli Cafe for a healthy spot to eat and fantastic coffee. A short 15-minute drive out of town and you'll arrive at Cadrona Distillery. This beautiful property produces boutique Scottish-style whiskey and other high-quality spirits. The distillery is the vision of Desiree Whittaker and her husband Ash, who had one request before he committed to the project.
Is it true that you said to your wife before you started producing any alcohol that no matter what, your only rule was you wanted to make a gin?
Absolutely correct.
And is it true that that gin just won a big global award?
Yeah, no, it did. Yeah, no, we were pretty surprised and over the moon, really.
Yeah. All right, so should we go have a look around and try some spirits?
Definitely.
Okay.
Ash has designed the distillery almost like a gallery to allow visitors to take a tour and learn how the alcohol is produced.
We've got the active ferment in here now.
Yeah.
So this is basically beer without the hops. Now don't breathe in too deeply.
Why, you'll get drunk?
No, can you smell that CO2 coming out of there?
Uh-huh. Yeah, it's pretty raw. I just put my head straight in.
Just put your arm in there and just feel the heat that's coming out of there.
So I'll put my head in there naturally.
So we're gonna drop this in and see what we can come up with.
So this is hot beer.
No, it's a wash, so it's a beer without the hops. There's no hops.
Now, are you going to try this?
Look, I've drunk plenty of it in my time.
Are you sure it's okay?
Yeah, you'll be fine.
Oh, wow. I don't want to say any brand names, but it does taste like a familiar beer that I know.
Yeah, but without the hops, so you'll notice that it's...
Yeah, wow.
So it's not that bad.
But I just had to try their award-winning gin.
Just be careful, it's 47%. Once again, it's very smooth, but it's quite floral.
Wow. Yeah. It just like exploded in my mouth.
Yeah, yeah.
No tour would be complete without a quick stop at Ash's favourite room where you can breathe in the smell of millions worth of single malt whiskey, not to be opened until 2026. Back on the other side of Lake Wanaka at Mount Gold is where I find my accommodation for the night.
So just a short 5-minute walk up the hill with some pretty awesome views, and this is my campsite for the night and the first time I have ever been glamping. Let me show you guys around.
Mount Gold Glamping's mission is to allow people to experience the beauty of nature in comfort and style.
Oh, so this is a Lotus Bell tent. Look how much room there is. It's like bigger than my bedroom at home. You got your own queen-size bed. And I pre-ordered this anti-pesto platter for my arrival. Thank you very much.